Hello everyone, this is Andrea Mengucci, and today I'm gonna record some league matches with Scapeshift. This is the deck that was born with the Battle for Zendikar, since thanks to Bring to Light you can have 4 additional copies of Scapeshift, and also thanks to Bring to Light you can tutor some spicy cards like Haunting Wilds that will let you search for more lands, so that like on turn 4 you can play Bring to Light for Haunting Wilds, and on turn 5 you can play either Bring to Light or Scapeshift to win the game. We have also some other cards to tutor for with Bring to Light, which are some cards like Eternal Witness, which sometimes you just run out of Scapeshift, or you wanna take your Damnation or sideboard card in general. That Eternal Witness is just a very versatile card, and I like it. There's not really much of a difference. The deck is very straightforward. We play 26 lands, and we have to play an additional color, a fourth color, to play Bring to Light, and we choose black. We choose it black because of basically there's no, like, you can choose white or black. You aren't playing that many different cards. I really like slaughter games out of the sideboard because there are so many decks in Modern that just are based on what card, like, I don't know, starting with the Scapeshift, with plenty of deck that I can mention. Like Living End, like, I don't know, all the combo decks. Damnation is a wrath effect, as is a Wrath of God or Anger of the God. I don't mind Damnation in the sideboard for matchups like Abzan or just Zoo in general. The deck is now positioned quite well, in my opinion, because people had moved from Tectonic Edge to Ghost Quarter as land destruction, and Ghost Quarter is quite bad against you, because if you are playing Scapeshift with 7 lands, they're just going to destroy one of your mountain, and you're just taking your mountain into play and dealing them like 3 more damage than what you would normally do. Also, it's very important to kill the right land when playing against Scapeshift with land destruction. Never kill Valakut, because it's always going to trigger no matter what. And if you have like Fulminator Mage and they make a misplay and tutor for 7 lands, you can just kill one of the steam vents or stomping ground, and they're just going to deal you 3 damage rather than the canonic 18 with 6 mountains and the Valakut. Other than this, you can ask more tip in the comments. I will be happy to answer you. I'm not really in love with this deck because it's, as I said, very easy to play. There's not much, your plan is so easy. You just have to play Ramp Spell and then eventually Bring to Light into Scapeshift, or just Scapeshift. In fact, Remainder are great because it buys you time, either taps creature or just counter draw, stuff like that. Yeah, the sideboard has many spicy cards. We have Dispel, Negate, Running Volley, Crumble to Dust, which is of course with 4 Bring to Light, let you have 5 cards great against Tron. Then we have Spellskite, just a good card in general against many decks. In fact, Spirit Ruin, Boggles, stuff like that. Destructive Revelry is a catch-all. We can get Blood Moon, we can get Leyline, we can get many things in general. Slaughter games, as I said. I like also having 4 Obstinate because they're great against Liliana of the Veil. And of course Burn. Now we have Cryptic Corrosion, which makes your affinity matchup way better, because now you have access to 5 Cryptic Corrosion. And in the hand we have Malira Silvok Outcast, which again, against Infect it's like game over, because they probably don't have any more Dismember after sideboard, so just Bring to Light for that and you win the game. Okay, that's the deck, and let's go down with the league.